Dalston is a part of London in transition. In the 7 years since the capital won the right to host the Olympic Games, transport links have improved, the art scene has flourished, and its reputation for nightlife is growing.
I've lived in London for almost 8 years. In that time, I've eaten in many Turkish restaurants, but it's Dalston I always head to for a taste of home. For me, the food here is as good as you'd find in Istanbul.
Ercan Cüce has worked in his family's restaurant for many years.
Londra'nın en eski ocakbaşı restoranı biziz. Etnik kimliğine Türk kimliği yani ağır basıyor, Türk ve Kürt kimliği. Ama bunun yanında Karabiyan, Afrika kökenliler. Ama şu anda bu değişimler. Şimdi buraya biraz daha öğrenimi yüksek işte çalışan kesimin doldurmaya başladı. Bu bölge benim hayatım yani doğmadım ama yani hayatım, çocukluğum bu bölgede geçti. Yani ilk kebap pişirmesini ki babamdan öğrendim bunu. Kendisi beraber çalışıyoruz. Dünyada herkese hitap ediyoruz. Brad Pitt diyelim yani o bile geldi yani Amerika kıtasına film için gelmişti.
Dalston is one of the most diverse parts of the capital. Here on Kingsland Road, the Turkish community is one of the most visible groups. Last August, rioting across London made international news. In Dalston, the Turkish community took to the streets to defend their shops against looting.
Dalston'daki isyanlar oldu. Olayların büyümesini engelleyen, kendi dükkanlarını koruyan, işte kapıların önünde sabaha kadar nöbet tutan Türk esnaflar oldu. Dalston benim hayatım.
Dalston's multiculturalism is what attracted Mehmet Ergen here. And in 2000, he set up the area's first theater. Last year, the Arcola moved into a new building.
Burayı keşfettiğim zaman da buradaki eski tekstil fabrikalarını, atölyeleri gördüm. Bunlardan iyi bir tiyatro çıkabileceğini düşünerek bir binaya girdim ve tiyatroya çevirdim. Yılda 25 yeni prodüksiyon çıkıyor. Bunlardan bir tanesi Türkçe. Türkçe oyunlara ya da Türkiye'den getirdiğimiz oyunlara rağbet var. Ama İngilizce oyunlara çok az sayıda Türkiye'li seyirci geliyor. Burada hem dünya repertuarını çok iyi bilmeyen, daha az eğitimli insanlar var. Hem buradaki dinamiklerin sahneye taşındığı, işte mesela Crime and Punishment in Dalston diye bir oyunla başlamıştık. Siyahlar ve Türkler arasındaki bir takım zıtlıkları bir Rus klasiği vasıtasıyla anlatıyordu. O tür yeni açılımlar yapmak için iyi bir fırsattı.
There are parts of Dalston that remain the same. It's still one of the most deprived parts of London, but there is a sense life is changing. I discover a gallery in the most unlikely of places, a semi-derelict housing estate. Local artist Nazir Tambuli started covering the estate with his work to create a good vibe for the people that still live here.
What I'm trying to create in this project is some kind of psychedelic, improvised, ongoing fairy tale book. Some people started to call me the comedy Picasso because the black and white work somehow reminisces what they think of Picasso's work, especially Guernica. Unless you live here, you have no reason to walk through these buildings. We're getting visitors to the state every day now. People take pictures and bring their kids. The neighbors started to get interested, the kind of neighbors who usually reject any street art. I find this very positive social function to art.
Nazir says having such a large canvas to work on is an honor.
Now that I got permission to cover 13 buildings in 3 months, for any muralist, this is a privilege. I would like to make fine art, not for elite, in a gallery. It's about the daily exposures to art, exposing the locals to art. The whole area is in sort of constant flux. It's the kind of neighborhood like the rest of East London where it's really cosmopolitan. Every language is spoken, every religion is practiced.
Before the end of the year, all Nazir's work will be destroyed when the buildings are demolished. But he doesn't seem to mind.
I'm Egyptian. If I want something to stay, I would have made it out of stone. I know it's temporary.
For a long time, Dalston was considered to be a dangerous spot where crime rate was high. But today, it's one of the hippest places in London. Dalston is nowadays playing host to many film crews, premieres, and underground parties. And let's not forget the kebabs either.